So the parts for the 15 meter trap are about the same as what they are for the 10 meter trap. The coaxial cable, this time I have a piece that is 30 inches long. On the first one I made it 6 inches long, longer than it should be, to have enough room for the working with the leads. Instead of adding 3 inches on each end of this, I'm going to add 2 inches and just make this 30 inches long for the 15 meter trap. I'm going to strip 2 inches of insulation off this end and 2 inches off of this end, and then pigtail the ends of it and separate the center and the shield. And then what I have left in the center of the coaxial cable, we need a length that is 26 inches, or about 66 centimeters. So inside here, just make that 66 centimeters long, and again, I'll strip about 2 inches off of the ends of the coaxial cable. And so first thing is to get busy with a trap and figure out where this is going to fit on here, and drill the holes for the coaxial cable. On the 3/4 inch coupler, I have put 2 pieces of masking tape on here just to mark some lines on it. And I'm going to use the same trick that I used on the loading coils. I'm going to use a piece of graph paper. Just go ahead and take the coupler. This trap, the 15 meter trap, is supposed to have 5 1/4 turns of the RG58 cable wrapped around it. And so I need to mark a line where I'm going to start and another line for where I'm going to end up at. So again, 5 1/4 turns for the coaxial cable. So we'll take this and set it on the graph paper here. And you just kind of have to look down inside of the pipe and get the part lined up within the grid lines here. We'll just take the marker. That looks pretty good. Hold that steady. Put a mark where that line's at. Mark where that line's at. Kind of eyeball it, look at it, and make sure we're on. And that looks like about 1/4 of a turn. So I've got 2 marks on there. I'll set this on the edge of my cutting board here. Line up the pin with the mark. Just draw a line across it like that. Line up the other one. A little off there, but it's not too bad. I think that's that'll work. Okay, we'll take some of the cable. Let's wrap around here 5 1/4 turns and see how wide it needs to be. Take this. Start wrapping around there. There's one. Two, three, four, five, and 1/4 turns. Kind of push the cable down, kind of center it there a little bit. And then the only thing we can do is just kind of give it a mark in the center of where the coaxial cable is supposed to be. Just kind of slide it around. My mark. I've got a cap on the marker. I'll grab another pin. It'll be right about there. Somewhere in the center of where that coax should be. If I turn that, you'll see it. And then we need to mark the other side. Make sure we got the right number of turns on there. Slide that cable back to where it was. It's going to be right in here. Let's kind of go back and check it. Maybe a little farther out. Let's start with a smaller 1/8 inch drill bit. See if we we get a hole drilled in this. That's a 13/64 inch drill bit. Now that should be enough to get the cable started in here. Like that. And then start wrapping the turns on it. And check the other mark and make sure and it lines up here. That's a lot easier to try the coax after drilling one hole. Got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1/4. So count up here from the first hole across on this side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then add 1/4 turn to this side. Check my marks. I want to leave a little bit of room just for play there. Looks like the mark's about right. Go ahead and drill the other one out. Okay, there's the two holes for the coax. Here I've stripped the jacket off of the ends of the coaxial cable. And again, it's a length of 2 inches. And in the center here, what I have left is 26 inches with the jacket left on it. 26 inches would be about 66 centimeters. And now I just need to push these back and take the awl and separate the center and the braid. Just kind of push that down like that. Push this down. Just kind of work that cable till you can get your awl or nail or something down inside there. And you'll bend this like that. Push your wires out of the way. After you get the awl in there, just bend that wire and push that dielectric out through the top. Push or pull it. You have to keep this braid bunched up like that. And after you do this, just pull it out like that. If you get a few loose wires on it, you can either trim or just kind of give this a twist like that. And there's one side done. It took a little bit of work, but I got the ends of the coaxial cable pushed down inside the trap. You can see it here. And on the other side, that's about, if you can see that, about how much cable I have left sticking on the inside there. And it took a little bit of work to get that cable to go in the other hole. What I ended up doing was started with the wire in one hole, wrapped the cable, and then when I got to the end, I was having a tough time getting that put in the hole. So I used a pair of pliers and put that in there. And just use the pliers to push the cable down inside the hole. And so now I've got to solder the leads together. On the 10 meter trap on the first one, I think I ran the center lead down through the inside of the coil rather than the braided shield. And most diagrams of traps that you see, you'll probably see the braided side pushed back through the inside of the trap and then the ends are soldered together. You can do it either way. It doesn't matter, but however which way you make the trap, make the other traps the same way. So I'm going to end up pushing a center lead back through the center here, and you see these are again only 2 inches long instead of 3 inches long. I'll have to strip off some insulation off of this and then push the wire back through here. But again, you know, whichever way you make the trap, whichever lead you push back through it, just make the rest of the traps the same way. And when you go to install the traps of the antenna, install the traps all in the same way too. Some insulation off of this center lead here. Kind of pick out which lead you want to use. Just solder this one. And again, I'm leaving about an inch of insulation on the end of it. There we go. I'll shove this lead back down through the inside. Bring that wire out. Just twist those together and solder them. Let's see where this trap is resonant at. See, I'm still on 28 megahertz. Let's change that. What are we shooting for? 21.2? Somewhere between 21.2 and 21.45. Just tuned up here. Oh, saw a spike. Oh. 1.4 at 21,500. That's getting pretty close to being resonant. It might be off just a little bit. Let's see here. Well, this looks nicer than the 10 meter trap. Well, I want to tune this or not. Let's see here. It's a little bit high. A little bit high in frequency means you kind of need to spread the coaxial cable apart just a little bit. Yeah. 21.6. Let's see, no, we need to push them together. If we pull them apart, it goes high. If we push them together, it should go low in frequency. There we go. 21.39. Looking pretty good. Let's see if we can squeeze that cable a little bit more. I may have to take it off there and kind of press that cable a little bit more. That may be about it. 21.38. That's not too bad. I think I'll go ahead and give it a try like this. My 15 meter trap. Let's go ahead and mark this. This is the center lead. This is where the cable goes in at. Just go ahead and mark it right there. 15. Just kind of push this down in here. Just a little bit here, like that. I'm going to shove it inside, but just kind of bend it. And that little mark ends up being about a half inch outside that connector when I straighten that back out. So that's where I'm going to strip off the insulation at. I'll go ahead and trim it. On the braided side, of course the braid moves around. There's a little more play in that, but I'm going to bend that the same way that I did the other side. This time I'll mark it to trim it off. I'm going to trim it off about like there. So when I pull that out, that's a little over an inch. That's at least 5/8 of an inch out or so. There's the red number 6 ring connector. Number 6 ring connector. I'll just take put that in a pair of pliers. Needle those pliers, just pull that off. Get that ready. Take the solder iron and put just a little dab of solder on this. Take the ring connector. I don't think that's going to move around too much. Flip this over. Take the blue number 6 ring connector. Pull the insulation off of that. Give that a moment to heat up. This is a piece of the 3/4 inch PVC pipe that I'm going to use as a connector. And again, that's about 1 5/8 of an inch long. This piece here already has a line drawn across it, and I'm going to use that as a reference. And so if you want to mark your pieces, you can go ahead and mark them like that. I've got about 3 layers of tape on both sides of it here for putting it in the vise, and then that way I don't scratch it up too bad. And if it's got too many scratches, it might be a little bit difficult to put together. So this time, since I've done this once before now, I'm going to mark this at about a half an inch, about 12 or 13 millimeters, and then I'll just draw a line across here and It just needs to be at least a quarter of an inch wide, maybe slightly wider. This part here is going to slip over the coaxial cable on the inside of the connector. Flip this around, put this over here on the opposite side. And I think to start with, I'll go ahead and mark it the same way that I did the first time. And just come down about a half an inch. Mark it. Just kind of go ahead and notch it out rather than drill a hole. Next, I think I'm going to take this small sanding drum and kind of clean up the inside here, kind of round it off, make it look nice and neat. Might be a little bit large, but it gives me lots of room to work with. Do that to the other side too. This side go in to move the wire around a little bit, and I'm going to kind of bend it like that. Slide this in here, push it down, and yeah, there's a little bit of space so it's not pinching the cable, and that looks pretty good. And then when I put the aluminum tubing in here, that will end up going up to about right there. And again, I'm going to come in about a half an inch. Just kind of draw it out. Yeah, if you want to, you can skip that step. And I thought I'd like to round that off a little bit and kind of make that look a little bit neater. And so, I'm using the lettering part as the bottom for the screw. Gotta turn this around. So my line is going to line up with the hole here. And there's plenty of room there. And on the other side, twist the braid there just a little. And then the pipe, well, I've got that turned wrong. The pipe will then fit like that, the screw head there. This is the half inch PVC pipe that's about 2 1/8 of an inch long. And the next step, of course, is to take the router this out so I can get this 5/8 inch aluminum tube to fit inside of it. I've got my two pieces of half inch pipe ready to go, and I've got that so that they will, so the tubing will slide on there. It's not too loose. We're going to use the machine screws to tighten that up anyway, so I want this to slide freely so we can get it all put together. Now I'm going to go ahead and drill the holes in the ends of this for the connections inside the trap. And really the hole just kind of needs to be just barely on the end of the aluminum tubing. Start putting this together. Okay, the side with the center I've already marked 15 meters, and this line is going to line up with where the coaxial cable goes in. Also on the other side here, where the cable goes in, there's a line there. On the center side, center lead, I'm going to go ahead and mark this part so that I know that goes to the center. I'm going to take the other pieces, we'll go ahead and mark these, put a little mark on one for the center. This is kind of optional. I don't think we need to mark those because we don't do any cutting on those. I'm going to stick that in there like that. Push it down in there good and solid. And then on the center lead here, let's go ahead and take that apart. So you can get an idea of where the tubing is supposed to go. So we'll take one of our parts here. Slide that together. This is going to fit like this. So the tubing needs to be kind of up in there, which is going to be about a quarter of an inch up inside of it. So I'm going to move this up so that my pipe is down inside of it and mark that with a piece of tape. Just kind of figure out where it needs to be. And you have to make leave room on the inside there. There's got to be enough room to get the screw inside. Probably about like that. Take the other side, put that together. Press it down in there firmly. Tubing is going to go in here like this. Also mark that with a piece of tape. Pull that down inside just a little bit. Bear in mind it's about a quarter of an inch. It's about 4 millimeters or so. On my half-inch pipe, I'm going to measure up about a half an inch. Put a little mark there. That's where I'm going to drill it out in the drill press. After I've got those drilled out, I'm going to take the marker and kind of mark these the way they ought to be. Peel some tape off. Let's go ahead and put a machine screw through there. See if we get to fit. And we'll just go ahead and mark across there so I can line up the holes. After taking it all apart, I connected the aluminum tubing with the sheet metal screws, and then I put my 3/4 inch PVC pipe parts back on there and lined those up where they should be. I've got those pushed in. So I'm just going to turn this around so that the holes line up here. I'm going to take one end, slide it in. I'll find my mark right here, where I marked it earlier, which is about where the screw is at. Just slide that on there. Slide it in place like that. Kind of move the tubing around and adjust it. And I get a machine screw started in it. Like that. The first time I drilled holes out here, and this time I've notched them out to begin with, and it just fit a lot nicer. So I'll take the other side here. There's my mark right there. The screws right here, so I'll kind of line it up. Slide the tubing on. Slide the PVC pipe parts on. Turn the tubing back around where the screw is facing up. And then try to slide this on here. May have to kind of pull on the tubing a little bit. Kind of push. There. And then the marks line up. Put the machine screw on the other side. And it'll go together like that. And that looks pretty neat. If you practice putting it together and taking it apart a couple of times, that'll make it a little bit easier whenever you need to glue the pieces together. And also, if you want to take a marker and put a mark on the center coupler wherever the screw's supposed to line up, and then that way you know where the tubing's supposed to be in case you get lost or something. But you know, if you need to put a few extra marks on it, just go ahead and mark it. That looks pretty good.